electricity, but still the life was so comfortable, arranged and managed. You know, the very word spoken in Sierra Leone again and again, manage. Let us manage. Let us manage. Everybody is a manager there. So we have managed our water system in such a way, whenever there was a rain, be it day or night, if it was night, any one of us awake, ask the other one, let us get up and collect the water. My wife used to stand there with the lantern, with the light, and the water falling from the rain, I used to fill the bucket and put it in the drum. I had two drums in my washroom. And whenever rain comes, midnight, day, night, we were there together to fill our water needs. As far as the food is concerned, plushas, the first day I tasted in Rokover, at a young man, he must be an old man now, Mr. Abu Eek. The first time I tasted the plushas there, I liked it. Right up to the last time. Even today, tomorrow, somebody has brought plushas for me to Mr. Lukman's house.
Beautiful.
Frozen, and I'm going to eat it.
So I can see you very much want to connect.
My daughter Shahida was a very good expert of cooking plushas.
I can see you like your plushas a lot. I'll come to Amir Sahib here for a second. Amir Sahib, unfortunately, also, what we also see is that there are some youngsters that are also recruited in the same similar manner. For example, we hear about these terrorist activities and ISIS and you know, all these other activities where young people are recruited using the verses of the Holy Quran, saying that Muslims need to dedicate their lives and Muslims need to sacrifice their lives. And they end up doing some things that we know are not in accordance with the teachings of Islam. How do we in the Ahmadiyya Jamaat ensure that our youth do dedicate their lives, but it's for the good cause, not for causes like that?
Yes, that they are.